Hello everyone, welcome you all. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to work with the cookies using Selenium with Python. Now let's start with the what is cookie. First of all, we need to understand. So let's start with this. So basically the cookies are a temporary internet files which you automatically creates when you are browsing some web pages. And what cookies are contains are the user information, like kind of login information. And suppose you are browsing for some information, the browsing details will be part of the cookies. So for example, so in Flipkart or Amazon, sometimes you will search for some products, right? So once you search for the product, from then onwards, whenever you open some pages, that automatically those products will be displayed in the sidebar, right? So how those pages are displaying the related ads, because the browser will hold those cookies information. So whatever you have done previous activities, everything will hold by the cookies. So as part of cookies, we need to, as part of automation, we need to also verify the cookies, whether your application is going to creating cookies or not, we are able to deleting cookies or not, so we are able to adding the new cookies or not. So these kind of things we need to verify. Now let us see what are all different operations we can do on cookies. So normally we can capture all the cookies from the browser, and we can count how many cookies are created for the browser, and we can read the cookies. Basically, the cookie information will be available in the pair format, key and a value pair. So we can read all the names along with the values, and we can add our new cookies to the browser. And if you want to delete a specific cookie from the browser, we can delete it, and we can also delete all the cookies. So these are the different actions we can perform on the cookies. Now let us see practical part. So let me open my PyCharm. I'm going to show you all these actions. Now here I'm just going to create another a new Python file. I will name it as cookies demo. Now let's okay. Now here I'm going to use to demonstrate these cookies, I'm going to use Amazon website. So before that, first of all, we need to import a web driver with Selenium package, and then we need to create the driver object. So driver is equal to web driver dot Chrome. I'm using Chrome as a browser, Chrome, and here we need to specify the location of your driver by using executable path parameter, and this is your location of your driver. And then we need to open the application. So I'm opening my Amazon website. Let's say web driver dot get, and here I'll just open my Amazon website. So this is your Amazon website. All right, so now once we have opened this website, as a first action, I will just capture all the cookies which are available from the web page. Okay, so first action is capture all the cookies created by browser. Okay, so how we can get all the cookies? So here WebDriver is provided a method called driver dot get cookies, get underscore cookies. So this method, this particular method will give you all the cookies which are created by the browser. So driver dot get cookies. And these cookies we can store in a variable. So I can just name it as a cookies is equal to. So cookies is a variable which contains all the cookies which are captured by driver.getCookies. Now if you want to find how many cookies have been created, so we can just use a len function, len of cookies. So this will give you how many cookies have been created for the browser. Let's print this value, print len of cookies. Okay, this will give you, this will print how many cookies, or we can say print number of cookies have been created. So this is how, and this statement will capture all the cookies from the browser. Now suppose if you want to print all the cookies along with the names and their values, I can just use one more print statement. Let's say print, I can just specify the this particular variable. Okay, because in this particular variable, all the cookies information will be stored as a dictionary format. So key and the value pair. Okay, now this statement will print all the cookie pairs. We can say cookie pairs because cookie is nothing but a combination of name and the value. So it will print, this statement will print all the cookies which are present in a web page, captured by the web page. Now let's run this code, run cookies demo. Now it is launching the web page. Okay, now we can see here. So totally it's captured 6 cookies, and this is information about the cookies from the web page. So let's say domain is equal to amazon.in. So this is the name of the cookie, this is the value of the cookie, and both are separating with the colon. And here expiry, so this is the expiry, and HTTP only is false, and the name is session and hyphen token. There are so many information will be there. So these are all different kinds of cookies. This is 1, this is 2, this is 3, 4, 5, and totally 6. Okay, so this information will be there. So we have captured all the cookies from the web page, and we have find the size of the cookies. That means how many cookies have been created, and then we also printed all the cookies. Now we'll see one more action, how to add a new cookie to the browser. So through automation. Now let me show you adding new cookie to the browser. How to add a new cookie to the browser. So if you want to add a new cookie, we have a method called. So first we need to have the cookie name and the value in a variable, then we can add that variable. Let me take a variable called cookie is equal to, and as I said, this is a dictionary. Cookie is nothing but a dictionary. So here I will just, the cookie name is, let's say name colon, and the value of the name is my cookie. So I'm just giving my cookie. So this is the value of the name. So this is the name, this is the value of this particular name. So this is one cookie. Okay, this is the actual cookie name. Okay, this is the actual cookie name, and for this cookie we have to also give the value. So how we can give? By separating comma, and value is equal to value colon, and in the single quote we have to provide some value. I'll say some number 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 0. Okay, so this is actual cookie, one cookie I'm adding. So the cookie name is this one, the value of cookie is this one. Similarly, if you want to add more cookies, you can still add it. So again, name is equal to one more cookie one, and value is equal to something else. By separating comma, you can add any more cookies. So this is completely one cookie. So this is the name of the cookie, this is the value of the cookie. Remember this, this is the name of the cookie, this is the value of the cookie. Now one, we need to create one cookie object first, and then we can add this cookie to your browser. So how we can add? We have driver dot add underscore cookie. This is a method, and here we need to specify this cookie object. This is a dictionary object. Now this particular statement will add cookie to the browser. So once it is added a cookie to the browser, so again we can capture all the cookies, and again we need to find out how many cookies are there, right? So it will say difference. Previously it was 6, right? Now we are adding one more cookie, but these cookies are dynamically created. So this number is not constant, so it will keep on changing. So whenever you're adding the new cookie or removing the existing cookie, every time we need to capture all the cookies, and then we need to find out how many are there, how many are deleted, and so on. So after adding this new cookie, again I will capture the all the cookies and find the length of the cookies. So these two statements, and again I can add these three statements one more time. So why? Because here I have added new cookie. So after adding the new cookie, I'm getting all the cookies again. I'm finding the length of those cookies, and then I'm printing those cookies again. Now in this particular list, whatever the cookie we have added newly, that should be part of this particular list. Okay. Now here I'm printing the number of cookies have been created after. So like print number of cookies after adding a new cookie. Okay. Now here again printing the all the cookies. Now let's run this code and see. Now again it is launching the page. Alright, so now we can see here. Alright, so now you can see currently I'm closing the page. Now so currently initially when I launching my browser, we have a 7 cookies. Okay, every time this is not a constant, every time it's keep on changing. Sometimes new cookies will be added and existing cookies will be removed. It will happen. So first initially whenever I launching the page, immediately captured cookies, at that time it will be 7. So here we have printed all the 7 cookies. Now after adding the new cookie here, now again I have counted here. If I see here, I captured all the cookies, and then I have found, I have find the length of cookies. So it is returning 8. because here we have added a new cookie. Then again, I have printed all the cookies, right? Now, whatever cookie we have added newly, that should be part of this particular list. Let us find out where this my cookie is created. Let's go and slowly create it. So now we can see here. This is the name of the cookie, my cookie, and this is the value of the cookie. Okay. Now this is created newly. So every time whenever adding a cookie or deleting cookie, every time we need to freshly take the all the cookies. Okay. So far we have seen how to capture the cookies from the browser and how to add a new cookie. And after adding the new cookie, again, we capture all the cookies and find out the length. Now I'll show you how to delete the cookie. We can also delete the cookie from existing file. Deleting cookie file. So here we have added a new cookie. Now currently this cookie is a part of the list. Now again, I'll remove this cookie or I'll delete this cookie. Okay. How we can delete the cookie? We need to know the name of the cookie. Okay. If you know the name of the cookie, we can easily delete. So here the name of the cookie is this one. My cookie is the name of the cookie. Now I'm going to delete the cookie which is already added by me. So here, how to delete the cookie. So again, the command is driver dot delete cookie. So this is a command, and here we need to specify the name of the cookie. So what is the name of the cookie? Is my cookie. This is the name of the cookie. So this will able to delete the cookie. After deleting the cookies, again, what we need to do is we need to again, same thing we have to do again. We need to capture all the cookies, find the length of the cookies. We can do that. So here, after deleting the cookie, so print the number of cookies after deleting the cookie. So what we are expecting here, for example, initially it is 7. We have added one more. It will become 8. After deletion, it should be again 7. So that's our expected, right? But the 7 is not constant always. Sometimes it will keep on adding and deleting. Something will happen. Now let's run this. So the command we have used is driver.get_cookies again. And we found the cookies. But if you want to delete the cookie, we use delete_cookie command. And we need to pass a name of the cookie. Now let's run one more time. Now it is launching the web page. Okay, now you can see now here, this time it is 6. This time it is 6. So first time when I launching my browser, the total cookies are 6. So after I have added a new cookie, so it becomes a 7. Okay, it becomes a 7. So here the total length is 6 initially. And here after adding the cookie also I have printed length. So it is here 7, it is returning 7 here. And again, after deleting the cookie, so after deleting the cookie, it should print again a 6. So something went wrong. Let us see here. But our cookie is not there. Yeah, it is still there. It is not deleted somewhere. Let me just try one more time. Okay, so let me try one more time. So here, deleting the cookie, how to delete the cookie. So this is the name of the cookie. So this is the name of the cookie. We have to give exactly the same name and driver dot delete cookie. And after that driver dot get cookies, we have seen dry cookies. And again, we have printed. Let me run one more time because these values are not constant. Every time this will change. I'll run one more time. Okay. So just a moment before running the next time. So after, it will take some time to delete actually. So what I can do is after deletion of this, I will just, I can say, okay, let's run this. If still not working, so let's put one wait time. Okay. So let me just run this code one more time. Run cookies demo. Now it is launching the page. Okay, I think still it is giving 7 is initial level and then 8 is added after adding 8 one is there, but still it is giving 8 after deletion also. So let's see what is the difference we have, and name is still there. So after deletion of cookie, we are getting all the cookies and again we have print. Okay, so here I have also added this code before here after deleting the single cookie. And but make sure we need to, whenever we start your code, so clear all your cookies from your browser so that you will get the result perfectly. Okay, so otherwise and randomly the browser will keep on adding and removing the different cookies whenever you're opening the new browser. So here, after deleting the single cookie, I have printed the length, and I can also delete all the cookies. So this particular statement will use it for deleting all the cookies from the browser. So delete diver dot delete underscore all underscore cookies. So this command will delete all the cookies from the browser. And once you deleted all the cookies, and the finally we are expecting zero as an output. Okay, there are no cookies will be present. Now let us run this code one more time. Run cookies demo. Now you can see. Okay, now you can see here this data is randomly coming. First initially 6 we have, and we have added one more cookie, so it becomes a 7. But while we were removing the cookie, so it is removing, but it is adding additional 2 more cookies randomly. And but finally, if you see the delete cookies, all the delete cookies, delete all cookies, it is giving 0. So that means there are no cookies are available. Okay, so this is how we need to work with the cookies. So there are different operations we can do. So far we have seen how to capture all the cookies from the browser, how to count number of cookies, reading cookie page and adding a new cookie, deleting a specific cookie by specifying the name, and we also seen deleting all the cookies from the browser. Okay, so that's all for this video. So thanks for watching this. Please subscribe my channel to get more updates on this. Thank you all.